WWE's perennial loser has defeated current and future Hall of Famers. Curt Hawkins hasn't appeared on Raw for a few weeks, but, rest assured, his unprecedented losing streak is still going as strong as ever. Jason Jordan defeated the former Edgehead on the November 2, 2017, episode of Main Event, handing him his 126th consecutive loss. But, believe it or not, it hasn't always been that way. In fact, Hawkins is a former WWE Tag Team Champion and has gone toe-to-toe with, and defeated, some of the greatest performers ever to step foot inside the squared circle. In this article, we look at five of the very best superstars that the perennial loser has beaten during his time in WWE. Number 1. The Undertaker. The man formerly known as Brian Major became Curt Hawkins in December 2007, and 3 months later he defeated the Mighty Deadman on an episode of SmackDown. It wasn't a one-on-one match, of course. That would have been insane. It was a 3-on-1 handicap match that saw Edge team up with his Edgeheads, Hawkins, and Zack Ryder, to take on the Phenom. Towards the end of the contest, Hawkins and Ryder were given chokeslams by The Undertaker before Edge, forever the ultimate opportunist, took out his WrestleMania 24 opponent with a spear to get the 1-2-3. Hawkins didn't pick up the pinfall, but the record books still state that he defeated one of the most iconic names in WWE history. WWE's perennial loser has defeated current and future Hall of Famers. Number 2. Shawn Michaels and Ric Flair. In March 2008, Edge, Curt Hawkins, Zack Ryder and Chavo Guerrero faced the star-studded team of Shawn Michaels and Ric Flair in a 4-on-2 handicap match in the main event of SmackDown. With Michaels and Flair down, Edge was about to crawl his way out of the cage for the victory when, all of a sudden, The Undertaker appeared to exact revenge for the previous week. He chokeslammed both Edgeheads and delivered a tombstone to Chavo, only to turn around to see that Edge had climbed over the cage to win. Again, Hawkins wasn't the one to get the victory over the two Hall of Famers, but he still defeated them. WWE's perennial loser has defeated current and future Hall of Famers. Number 3. The Miz. Can you imagine Curt Hawkins winning a title from The Miz in modern-day WWE? Well, that's exactly what happened when the two were involved in the same match in July 2008. The A-lister was a tag team champion with John Morrison, and the two attempted to defend their titles at the Great American Bash pay-per-view against three other duos, Curt Hawkins and Zack Ryder, Jesse, and Festos, and Finlay and Hornswoggle. However, without even being involved in the result of the match, The Miz and Morrison lost their titles after Hawkins pinned Jesse to win his one and only championship in WWE. WWE's perennial loser has defeated current and future Hall of Famers. Number 4. Matt Hardy. Curt Hawkins had spent a year back in development when, in July 2010, he returned to the main roster with a new tag partner by the name of Vance Archer. The two teamed up on an episode of SmackDown to take on the dysfunctional duo of Matt Hardy and Christian, who weren't exactly on the same page 2 weeks prior to their participation in a Money in the Bank ladder match. Christian walked away from Matt midway through the contest, allowing Hawkins to pick up a shock pinfall victory over Hardy following a heat-seeking elbow from the top rope. WWE's perennial loser has defeated current and future Hall of Famers. Number 5. Apollo Crews. In terms of main roster singles victories, 2016 was the greatest year of Curt Hawkins' career. He defeated Brandon Scott and Chase Silver in dark matches on Main Event, and then, out of absolutely nowhere, he actually won a televised WWE match. In a 1-minute, 40-second encounter on SmackDown, Hawkins shocked the WWE Universe, and the commentary team, who couldn't seem to believe what they just witnessed, when he rolled Apollo Crews up for the 1-2-3 to pick up a rare clean victory. If anybody thought that would prompt a series of victories for the former tag team champion, they were wrong. He hasn't won a single match since. Send us news tips at fightclub@sportskeeda.com.